Hello folks, Tiso here. The new Theater Mechanicus event is out, and it's a little different than last time. This is a tower defense minigame, and you will need to have unlocked Inazuma to play. In this event, we can get 420 Primogems, some talent scrolls, and other materials. Your goal is to complete challenges to get currency. Here's the list of challenges now. They're all pretty easy to get, just play the game to unlock it. Some of them are increasing your mastery level, which is just your EXP for playing the game, defeating a certain amount of opponents, clearing certain stages without leaking more than 15 enemies, and having 400 points at the end of stage 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. This event is easier than the first time around, but it might be confusing at first. So I will break down how the event works this time around and give you some tips on clearing it. There are a total of 10 different stages we can play. The later stages will unlock in a couple days. You can also check your mastery level, which you get by playing. Note that there is an EXP cap that you can get each day. Increasing your level will increase your starting gold, unlock more towers, and give you more buffs to choose from. The stage challenges is your experience. You'll need to get over 400 experience on the even number stages for some of the challenges. To get 400 EXP, you just need to complete the stage and lose no more than 10 integrities. Integrity is your life in this event. The ones you can really control are selecting 5 Ominous Sticks and 5 Courage Sticks. Ominous Sticks will provide a negative effect on your towers, and the Courage Sticks will provide a buff to the enemy. Try to have a decent power line before you start going crazy on these buffs. Once you start, the enemies will spawn from the purple portals and go to the blue portals. You can see the path by looking at the light on the ground. The most common combo is to use Hydro and Cryo Towers to keep enemies frozen. To keep things more consistent, you should have 2 Hydro and 2 Cryo Towers in each intersection. After leveling up, you should also build a Charity Tower next to your damage towers in order to slow down the enemies even more and get extra currency. The currency is used to build more towers and choose your fortune. The fortune is a new system this time around. These fortunes will be leveling up your towers. There are 2 main types of fortunes, the Fortune Sticks and the Courage Sticks. There is a third type that is pretty much a strong buff to your towers. The Courage Sticks will buff the enemies. You can try to select 5 of these throughout the course of the stage in order to get that extra 60 EXP at the end. The Fortune Sticks will be buffing your towers. Some of them will have a fickle effect that you can see from the purple on the bottom. This will give you a negative effect on your towers, such as decreasing their attack or destroying a random tower. If you don't like any of the 3 fortunes, you can always reroll and draw again. If these stages are getting kinda hard, then don't choose any fickle fortunes. That 60 EXP at the end is not that important. Since you are limited on the number of towers you can build each stage, you should not focus on more than 4 element types per stage. On the top left, you can see what elements will not get any fortunes on this stage. And here are some general tips. If you can, try to put 1 or 2 Hydro Towers next to 2 Cryo Towers to keep enemies frozen. You can add in Electro Towers to keep damaging enemies while they're still frozen, or you can add in Pyro if you really need that extra punch. You can also use your playable character to help out. A good character to use is a Hydro Catalyst user, since they can apply the Hydro effect on enemies without the Hydro Tower. Even though you won't do damage, you can help out your Cryo Towers and freeze enemies even easier. You can also use a Sword user with a charge attack that knocks enemies back. If you happen to have Jean, you can use her elemental skill to yeet enemies off the stage as well. Using a character to attack is optional. You can clear each stage with just towers alone. And later on, when you unlock the tandem mines, those are very good to place at the end in case you have an emergency leak. A mine will disappear after blowing up, but you can just build a new one in its place right after. And that's pretty much the general tips for this event. If some of these stages are looking pretty rough later on, I will make another dedicated guide to beat each stage with just towers only. Anyways, that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, have fun out there, traveler.